Well, we'll do a necromancer run. We'll take a look at the new spell in there. Welcome back once again, wizard, to the ruins of the universe. Eons pass while you slumbered, and you've slept walk across many worlds. Weep for Avalon, and whoops, I dropped all the books that don't have dark magic in them. So only things with the letter D over here. So Wave of Drive is a 3 cost. I mean, 22 damage in a cone. Ain't bad. Increasing range on this bad boy is going to be nice. Cones work well with range. I'm a little sad it doesn't have Ignore's Line of Sight for its cone, like some of the other cone ones. Looking at you, Cone of Fire, or whatever you're called. My brain's not going to be super functional today, but we'll get through. Who's the real evil wizard here? What's going on, Sally? Going through the big D. Don't mean Dallas, mean Doc. Doc. Maybe that'd be one of the upgrades? Possibly. Or I think my favorite cone spell upgrade is for Cantrip Cascade. You can, instead of doing a cone, you can make it a burst. And oh, it's so good as a burst. I actually think I like that better than the you get to cast a level 2 spell along with it. I had a nice run with that on the main channel. Main channel YouTube. So obviously we're gonna start with Deathbolt, because I mean, come on. But I'll be curious. Wave of Dread, it seems like fear. If we have some skeletons, enemies are gonna be forced to run away, not just from me, but from like anything on my team. So Deathbolt makes some sense there. We'll probably do Soul Battery. There's a lot of fun choices in Dark. Just trying to think ahead a little bit. I mean, Restless Dead is in here. Restless Dead's always a good time. Bone Barrage. Yeah. We'll grab Deathbolt and see where things take us. Need Dark Form. I would be into more, like, form spells. Like, Lightning Form is pretty cool. I like that it has an upgrade. Whoa, 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 hold on. Deals 1 dark damage to the target. What? What? 1 dark damage. Slain units erase the skeletons. I didn't see a change to death bolts in the patch notes we were just looking at. But we're doing 1 damage and we're applying fear. Oh, hold on now. Yeah, new challenges. That's the other update, but 8 here. Yeah, nothing about Deathbolt changing, but clearly it's very different now. This has to be a mistake. 1 damage. That can't be right. That's not terribly tenable. 5 minion damage. There's a lot of dark immunity, but like there's plenty of ways around, is what I would have said if I wasn't looking at this 1 damage. Good lord. It's gonna take 4 casts to kill a bat and they run away from you? I don't know. I mean, Deathbolt doesn't even mention fear here, does it? Skeletons of flying units can fly. It doesn't even mention fear here. That's why I'm not sure if this is intentional or not, but that doesn't seem right to me. Game's broken. Deathbolt, if it doesn't do like, what was it? It's supposed to be 9 damage, right? God damn. No, that's no good. like Deathbolt here. Gains 3 damage when it slays a target, and it only lasts until the next realm. At 1 damage, you have to kill a bunch of stuff just to get up to the original damage dealing. Adding cold damage, it's the same as the base damage. That's just 2 damage. Did Fear get glommed onto other dark spells? That's kind of what I'm curious about right now. Let's, like, no, untenable. You can't do this now. 2 damage, huge! Oh my god, he got out of my range. Listen, I'm gonna hold the bat here. Help me. I don't... The 1 damage, like, that's the part that's fucking with me. Any other damage things change in here? 24. Just summons a Gosha. Mercurize. 2 poison. 2 physical. Still does 200. Toxin burst. 1 poison damage and apply poison. 18. I think just Deathbolt lost its damage. From what I'm seeing here. But yeah, I guess we'll apply Life Drain on something and see if it gets Fear. But like, Deathbolt went from being a very nice starter spell to this is now garbage. I wouldn't touch that with a 10-foot pole. Scepter of Sorrow. Reroll. Dragon Staff, Arcane Amplifier, Winter Lynx are pretty nice. Sorcery Wand, that could be big right now. 2 radius, 2 damage, 25% damage. Radius range, 25%. 25%, will this even make it to 2? Sounds like a stealth nerf to Deathbolt. That's not like a nerf, that's a hit job. That you hired a man with a gun who has killed Deathbolt. Deathbolt's dead now. I feel like a nerf. Oh, that's a narf. Yeah, that's a narf. That's a hyper nerf. Was this man in a clown suit? He could have been. He could have been in a clown suit. Incomprehensible nerf. This has to, I'm gonna say that has to be a mistake. No way they intended it to be 1 dark damage. You would need to make this spell cost nothing to justify that. I'm gonna take the sorcery wand just to see if we go all the way up to 2 damage. Inconceivable!
New orders, Agent 47. Kill Deathbolt with a banana.
2 damage, everybody! We did it! We doubled our damage! Life Drain, not a sorcery, so alas. All right, does it fear them? Maybe it was supposed to apply fear for one turn. You know, that might be it. Unmarked, because it was meant for a future patch. Like, 1 damage is so bad that there's no conceivable world where, like, that's an on purpose. That's where I am right now. 50% resistant, 1 whole damage. Amazing. So yeah, we fear them for 4 turns. I want to, like, restart the run because Deathbolt's is so bad that this is just unacceptable. Sounds like it's time to get into Discord. Oh, well, it sounds like it's time to go into the, like, report a bug section and be like, hey, Deathbolt died by mistake. Because, like, there's no way that's intentional. My fingers were misplaced. I didn't walk right. Oh my, like, I don't even... Deathbolt's useless. We all learned something. We learned that we can't use Deathbolt right now. I'm out. Abandoning that run. No, no. No way. Welcome back once again, Wizard, to only dark spells and no deathbolt. Yeah, that was just a practice run. God, I wish we had deathbolt. I wish we had deathbolts. But no, no, it's fine. It's fine. Life drains cost being relevant, right? Like, it doesn't ever come up. How do you upgrade Death Chill in Necro Run? I'm thinking I might go with the ice skeletons. That way we get a different damage type reliably spawning on the floor. Because with Death Chill, living units become icy skeletons. They have ice balls. They do ice damage. I feel like that's the direction I want to go. Mass Death Chill, though, that could be pretty nice, too. But getting additional damage types seems pretty sweet. Star Blesser. Are you sorcery spells? No, arcane spells. So not what we're looking for. Reroll. Probably just gonna go for a nice ruby heart. Well, let's stop walking that way right now. Rotting zombies. Can't hurt them. So I think we're getting a ruby heart, but we'll go for a ruby heart with a nice chaos belt. Tremendous sense of value. No poison to worry about either. Crowded over here. You guys are standing between me and the one spell point I would like to have. Thank you. Death Chill. This will help quite a bit. More health, please. Seven more casts. Probably gonna need mana potion. Yeah, mana potion's gonna happen. Two casts per spriggan. Friggin. Almost there. Walk around you. And we're free! Doo-doo. I'm a bit sunburnt, and I'm going to the beach again tomorrow. Anyone have any advice? Huh. I don't think I do. Probably aloe vera. Treat your skin right. Rash guard? I don't know what rash guard is, but I trust Gomber. Reroll. Enchantment wand. This could be it. This could be huge. Big umbrella. Four range. It's the worst enchantment wand ever. Chris looks like a dude that goes to the beach. I used to. Honestly, Crackle Darkener makes perfect sense. Crackle Darkener makes perfect sense. I'm gonna start with Crackle Darkener. Crackle Darkener, save me. Oh, hell yeah, Crackle Darkener. Crackle Darkener, when you're doing enchantments that do dark damage, is pretty sweet. Gotta say. Multiple turns worth of, like electricity shooting out? Dark starts today. Nightmare Aura will be fun with this too, yes.
Thank you.
What if I still want to get my pasty white skin a little bit more tan? Will more sun now make it darker? We'll just get more irritated. I feel like that's just going to do more damage than anything else. I don't think you're going to improve your tan that way. Yeah. I wouldn't advise trying to tan while sunburned. I don't know how much of what I know is just like old wives' tale nonsense, but I think that's how you get like those weird little sunspotty things on your skin. That's almost certainly just something my mom made up to make me wear sunblock. Doodle, 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 doodle. Yeah, Crackle Darkener's the way to go. Well, I gotta look at a Dark Wand, but it had to be pretty sweet to make me switch away. Dark spells and skills gain 6 damage and 2 number of summons. Yeah, that's not so good. Melanoma Can-Can. I think I'm just going for a ruby heart. Might get sun poisoning. No one wants sun poisoning. Wave of... No. Wave of dread. You don't try retoasting a flaming marshmallow? Says you. Gonna lose a turn. Lose another turn. Allow myself to get poisoned, just be careful. Yeah, just having the spread. Spread of lightning damage is pretty sweet. God, I'm gonna lose a lot of turns walking this way. Walk this way! It sucks, don't walk this way. Just wave a dread. Would Crackle Darkener work with Nightmare Aura? Yes, it would. Whenever an enemy takes dark damage, deal that much lightning damage to up to 2 enemy units in a 6-tile burst. With Nightmare Aura, the complication is it's not a lot of damage, and we can't make that damage go up, but it would still spread lightning around. assuming they're taking the dark damage, there's the arcane part too. Really, like, now that we have Crackle Darkener. Carnival of Pain is what we want. Which is also an enchantment, so yeah. Like, we're gonna increase the duration of our enchantments. We'll use Wave of Dread to try and, like, corral things that we don't necessarily have the power to hurt. Because even if they're immune to dark damage, we can make them run away. And that's just time for Crackle Darkener and Carnival of Pain and Death Chill to do their grim, grim work. Mass Death Chill is looking a little bit more appealing now? But yeah, I think Carnival of Pain is definitely on the menu now. Time to get a Mr. Wizard's Wild Ride. Crackle Darkener was a sweet, sweet find. Yeah, I guess it's Ruby Hearts. Anything that doesn't have, like, a vampire is fine by me. Liches are also annoying. So this looks fine. 50% resist in the dark is A-okay. Ravens are 75% resistant? Nope, just 50. Alright, so this comes with a teleporter. I would like a teleporter. Carnival of Pain requires 4 spell points. Me count bad. How did you get these around me, you bastard? Hell yeah. Wave of Dread. Wave of Dread's pretty sweet. Like, look at that cone. Well, I'll be poisoned. Because it's a cone, we can kind of, circumvent line of sight. It's just this jackass left. Blinking randomly. Oh god, how many turns do you last? 3 turns? How much health do I have? I might need the teleport. Ah, we're good. Happy Wednesday, Quark! Doo-doo-doo, Carnival of Pain. Now I feel like we have a very good engine here. A very good engine. Skull Necklace, Dragon Staff, Purple Curse, Scaly Curse. Double Mana Potions or a Teleporter? Double Mana Potions. Did Carnival get nerfed? Whenever an enemy takes physical fire or lightning damage, the 3 nearest enemies take that much dark damage. Lasts for 3 turns. That seems normal. Woof. Woof. I mean, I could, like, erase this level in 1 turn, but that 1 turn's gonna suck. Unless I start down here when I'm only taking 3 damage. Well, not entirely true, this guy. I just need 1 turn to set up. I will do it. I will. There's my 1 turn to set up.
Hey,
Remember when I had a great time hanging out in New York with my sister? Turns out she tested positive for COVID this morning. Oh no! Well, he's feared. His life drained. Guess we'll keep death chill on him too. And then we fear him again. We death chill him. We fear him. Reapply life drain. Well, now he has a lot of protection. That's annoying. Alright, he no longer has 125%, so we're gonna fear the man, death chill the man, life drain the man. Ugh. Well, aren't you fun? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All right, he's no longer completely immune. Death dice. Screw you. Wrath links. Enchanting disc? Yes. Yes, please. The disc is for death chill, potentially for life drain. Carnival of Pain, we're looking for finger sixes. But that disc is pretty sweet. I think this is just another situation where if we just have one turn of setup, we can win pretty fast. Carnival of Pain, Wave of Dread. Not looking forward to the fourth at all. Doo-doo. Over here, Jimmy's out of town, Andrew's out of town. We'll probably not do too much. Like, I'm gonna stream tomorrow. So, you can hang out with me. Can't believe you would do that. I've got Baldur's Gate 3. That's right, you got your online game to play. Fire Frenzy. You know, Witch Whistle makes perfect sense here. One thing I found funny is I live in a state. Fireworks are illegal. Can't have fireworks if you're not, like, you know, an institution that has special permits. But in my mailbox, I got coupons for fireworks from a place in Maine. They're like, come buy fireworks. Look at this man, completely resisting the dark damage. Whatever will I do? The answer is Carnival of Pain. They do high explosives, shoot them off way too low. Man, when private citizens get their hands on mortars, that's the fun stuff. Growing up, that was my family's, like, they would go out and get, like, the biggest mortars they can get. My dad built homemade PVC pipe launching tubes for them. Incredibly unsafe. Insanely illegal. I want to start with the Witch Whistle, because it'd be fun, but not at the expense of losing a bunch of health to a stupid Bone Knight. Carnival of Pain. Out of all the people that could have survived, out of all of them, it had to be you? Man. That's a bummer. Alright, well, we knew we were gonna need something. And the answer is probably gonna be just get Twilight Gaze. And now I think that's it for spells. Like, I'm pretty pleased with our setup here. We don't even need Death Chill most of the time, but it'll probably come up again. Let's get Witch Whistle. No, no! Witch Whistle, thank you. Perhaps a reroll. Ruby Heart with a teleporter, please. Well, that looks like fun. Yeah, no, this is fine. Alright, I'm gonna start, Pounce. Fairly convinced someone's gonna get shot. Wave of Dread. Bing! Man, Crackle Darkener. If you find Crackle Darkener while doing the Necromancer run, challenge over. Challenge complete. Alright, Dark Lord for charges damage. They had a white wedding chair and stuff inside the building for rental. We decided to make a cannon that a tube of grease would fit in. Shot that bitch off inside one night while drinking, splattered grease all over the hundreds of white wedding chairs. His worker had to clean that up the next day. Was a terrible idea. So, one thing that was fun for me when I was a college student is, like, I studied a bunch of stuff, you know, just whatever I was interested in. Did, like, 3D animation for a lot of it, but I was also really into practical effects. So, like, I did makeup, prosthetics designs. And the fun part for, like, doing special effects and practical effects was every once in a while, like, you need a tool. So, like, I got to use, like, the budget from my senior thesis and stuff to buy and put together stuff like, you know, air cannons. Because if you're, like, this character's being shot and you need, like, blood to splatter on the wall behind them, either you do that with squibs, which are arguably a little dangerous for a college student to try and, like, all right, we're gonna put an explosive on you and it'll blow a bunch of fake blood out of you. It's like, eh, hopefully it won't be real blood. So, you know, the safer way is you make, you know, a pressurized tube filled with blood. So I got to make, like, potato cannons that I use to, like, splatter brains on walls, and large syringes that I would use to inject foamed latex and stuff into the molds I was making. But I love potato guns and cannons. Our cannons were fired with acetylene gas. See, that's fun and cool, and I do have some good books on how to make those too. But we just did nice pressurized air so people wouldn't die. But still a lot of fun. Honestly, you know, I was thinking about taking Dark Lord, but Arch Enchanter. More duration, more damage. That works almost better. We'll take Dark Lord next. We are gonna want Soul Harvest, but, like, funny enough, not that important when we're doing this. Oh, another disc? Gonna take another disc. In situations where we need to use our good Death Chill, more radius is more better. I might also look for and grab Time Striders. Just one turn to set up. A turn to cast Carnival of Pain is all I really need. Before we start the infinite duration lightning spreads. Witch Army, go get them! Move out! This is good stuff too. Like, whatever survives has to contend with an army of witches. Witches that do dark damage that turns into lightning damage for the surrounding buddies. Which means we get more witches. Here, let me help you guys out. Here, let me help more. Yeah, radius on death chills, definitely gonna be good. We used to override the safeties on the scissor lifts, had extended them like 30 feet in the air and just drink up there, drive them around fully extended on uneven terrain. We were begging to die. You are an OSHA nightmare. A witchy layer of insulation, yeah. Welcome back, Fortuna.
I returned from the wilds. Tell me about these lich bombers you got killed while explaining.
So, if an enemy has the lich modifier, they get to leave a phylactery behind, and they can't be killed until you destroy the phylactery. But some enemies in the game blow themselves up. Like, that's what they do. Like, bombers blow themselves up. Living scrolls of lightning, like they churn themselves into a spell and die. So even if they're a lich, they'll die because they self-sacrifice through their damage and they just leave a jar behind. Just sits there doing nothing. I find it very funny. Mass calcification. Non-undead allies are instantly killed and raised as bone shambles. We could take our witches and turn them into bone shamblers. It needs to be phylactery liches. There is an enemy that is a giant phylactery that makes soul jars for other things. I don't think it makes a soul jar for itself, though. That would be neat. Man, that mass calcification could be a funny, like, last move after we make a bunch of witches, but... I think I just want another golden stopwatch. Immortal phylacteries. How completely immune to dark are you? That sure will be hard for me. Yeah, Ophan definitely uses other creatures, essentially as soul jars. Weird nun game, Indica, is even weirder than I thought it would be. Why does that sound familiar, Indica?
Thank you very much.
Thank you for the bitty bits. Look at that perfect diamond of witches. Death chill. My squad rolled up. I appreciate the bitty bits. I think now I'll take Dark Lord. Twenty dark damage followed by 20 ice. Mona, thank you for gifting a sub to a level 19 Magikarp. One day you're gonna grow up to be a big old Gyarados. Believe in yourself, Magikarp, believe. Reroll. Wait. No time striders. Spark gold. Okay. Thought that would start the hype train. Hype train is close. You're almost there. I could see it at the top there. I don't know what you need left, but you have 1 minute and 10 seconds to start the train. That spark gold actually makes perfect sense for how we're playing right now. That will completely... Audrey, thank you for gifting us up. Hype train has begun, says the screaming little lizard emote. Thank you for starting a train. My god. Level's wide enough that I had trouble getting the proper loop of damage going, but there we go. Go forth, my witches. Oh, liches! Someone suplexed the train. I do want to play Final Fantasy VI again. I haven't played it in a long time. It's been on my mind. Right. Completely immune to dark. Screw you. Now you're not. There should be an enemy that changes its type to the first damage type it receives and gains 100% immunity to it. The bosses have similar things. They have large health pools, and basically the way the game works is if they take damage, they gain 10% each turn from the damage types they receive, which means you have like 10 turns before they're 100% immune. They are frustrating. Yorgamander, I'm looking at you. Now, a Carnival of Pain. Heal for 50% of the damage dealt. If the damage killed the enemy, the bolt coming out of that enemy deals 2x the damage. Every 3 kills, cast your Fiery Tormentor spell. So, Carnival of Pain has some interesting upgrades. I'll probably not do the healing one, even though I like the healing one, because I've done it too many times. Robe of Twilight. Once again, putting some holy magic into the mix. But Spark Gold's gonna be nice. Anytime someone takes lightning damage, they'll also take holy damage, and the dark immune ones, that'll probably keep us from running into, like, the last dude's immune to dark damage. Carnival of Pain. You shouldn't have hit me with that kind of magic. That's on you. Didn't even get to do the second part. Boo, boo, boo. I'm out of here. I don't even like this guy anymore. Let my witch and ghost army take care of these bears. Or not. Twilight Gazem. Fearm. And run away while he's cursed. Bang. Alright, we're here for Robe of Twilight. We got some pretty sweet gear for a challenge run about dark damage. Righteous March, Chaos Casting, Echomancer. This looks like a reroll to me, but after I portal key. Doo-doo. Sinister Hourglass, maybe? More duration's always good. 421, thank you for gifting those subs! Enjoy your sub perks, everyone. Hey, Blindy got one. Ba 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 da ba. Let's re-roll. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Do do do. Yeah. I think I'm just gonna go over here. True Lammy Sue. Last time I was speaking with Blindy, they were... I'm always gonna say Blindy as opposed to blind. They were tracking out Caves of Cud, which was fun. I hope they continue to enjoy it. Caves of Cud obviously has a special place in my heart. Do I want a Twilight Gaze first before I cast? It's probably a smart idea. How much damage? Oh, I don't want to be frozen. That's the tricky part here. Oh yeah, I watch his Dwarf Fortress stuff. I also, when he was checking out Manor Lords, I was interested in Manor Lords. But I'm happy branched out some Cud lands. Cud's good stuff. Twilight Ace. Carnival Pain. Wave of Dread. And now it's just me and this man, and also all of my witch wives. Death chill 'em. Life drain 'em. Twilight Gaze, keep that on. Wave of Dread 'em. So he's feared, but I didn't see him move anywhere. Three turns of Death Chill. Interesting, when he has fear, he just doesn't take actions, but he doesn't run away. More witches. Five turns. Four. Two. One. Twilight Gaze. Death Chill. Probably better off getting Life Drain in there again, too. Stop running away. Dude, stop. Wave of Dread does 31 damage. I mean, given his incredible health total. 2, 1. Come on, he's always running out of my range. I mean, the witches beget more witches. We're just gonna allow the witches to do most of the work here. While keeping Twilight Gaze on as much as possible. That said, making it remove 100%, worthwhile investment. That'll make him take a 50% additional damage once this runs out. 10 turns. He just keeps running away! Wonder why he's running away. Like, he does holy damage. This is weird. I've never seen an enemy just continuously. Maybe he's trying to get around my wall. My witch wall. That could be it. Alright, Twilight. Now he's taking an additional 50% dark damage from all these hits. Now he doesn't have fear on him. I think he's just trying to get around them and reach me. I unfortunately for him, I just keep on pooping out witches. My high fiber diet really coming in clutch here. Just pooping out witches. Just plink away at him. His health bar is just a tiny red dot. Health bar has disappeared. And he's gone. The high score chart there is a little skewed, giving Witch top billing, but it's because Witch had plenty of time to kill something with thousands of hit points. Alright. Honestly, Master of Time is probably the right way for me to go. Redeal 50% of all physical poison, lightning, and ice damage dealt to enemies by enchantments. Now, Carnal Pain is an enchantment. I think Fae Malevolence and Master of Time. I'm going to grab both of these. You would think I want Soul Harvest, but like, I barely have to cast these spells. Except for Twilight Gaze. Horde Mancer, Shield and Minions, Moonspeaker. You know what we should do is Multimancy. Number of targets for Carnal of Pain. Bringing that up to 4 would make a difference. Not much of one. What's up? I suppose I could have like a skull hanging out. Now that's a level. Some immunities. Wow, there's a safe spot? There's multiple safe spots? It makes no sense. But yeah, all right, I'll start here. Twilight Gaze. Carnival of Pain. And Wave of Dread everyone into oblivion. Goodbye, the level. We have some survivors. Can they handle my 2, 4, 6, 12? 24 witches? I doubt it. Death chill. Yeah, no, this is an unfair run. Yeah, we'll have a giant floating skull lich will hang out, be part of the team. At this point, I think finger six is the most exciting thing for me to find. You know what? Soul Harvest is a freebie. It's something I would like. I'll take it. Idol of Fiery Vengeance. This is a good test level for us, because we got vampire counts. Ah, basilisks. Alright, Grey Gorgons. Eagerly distinct. Gonna start where a Gorgon will require several turns to get line of sight on me. Actually, right here. Takes like 10 damage, but I'll have nice cone. Yeah, this is fine. I wonder if items will get traits. What kind of traits do you think? Oh, you know what happens? That's incredible. So basically, if I cast a spell that is dark, which every spell is, my robe shoots out a little beam, and if we get lucky and the dark beam shoots out, we got a little engine. Every time the witches show up around you, I hear Beyonce say, "Okay, ladies, now let's get in formation." Twilight Gaze. dark, lightning, uncrackle, darkener. Oh, I see what you're saying. I feel like equipment's already strong enough that probably not. Like, if it were to scale with the other things you're doing, that might be a bit much. Alright, we want to keep Carnival of Pain going. Beauties. I'm not seeing enough folks to cast Quiet Gaze just yet. I might just release my bag of spikes here. There we go. Do 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 do. Ya da da da. Soul Harvest. All right, spike balls. I'll let you guys handle the rest. Sorry, is that man coming for me? Twilight gaze him. Multiple items with the same trait reaches tiers of body. Like, you'd just be overwhelmingly powerful at that point, I think. One more turn of Twilight. Bing. See, that can be interesting, like stacking items with the same affinities to get extra bonuses or create, like, maybe even set stuff, like games where you have, like, you have two out of three set and you get a special ability because you have two out of three of the set, and just keep on, like, oh, three out of three and get the full set. I guess it could be four, like you could have a staff, a robe, a hat, and shoes. Set bonuses would be interesting. Master of Space. I mean, as a freebie, Master of Space is pretty sweet. Even as not a freebie, it's pretty sweet. Bunch of immortals? Annoying. Man, that load time. I love when I start the level. And the level just disappears. Immortals are annoying, though. Spread the lightning around. Good, good. Carnival Pain again. As long as we have multiples, got reason to cast it. Yeah, Death Dice. Interesting, that dark damage doesn't bounce around. We have a Dreadwill. Didn't. I'm stuck behind the skull until it blinks, and it never will. This is horrible. There we go. That's Twilight Gaze. Turn the carnival back on since everyone's nice and close to me. Oh, he still had another one? Come on. Twilight Gaze. Death Chill. Life Dream. Wave of Dread. There we go. Like house bonuses in auto chess games? God, come on! Master of Space is pretty sweet here. Alright, we got our Twilight Gaze upgrade. Honestly, if damage kills the enemy, it shoots out a double damage bolt. Let's do that one. Wave of Dread doesn't have an upgrade yet. We're not using Death Chill too often. It's mostly a mop-up spell at this point. Now that I have a skull hanging out next to me, I might take Enchantress Boon. But we should probably take Horror. Horror is pretty good. Not doing fire. Don't really have undead. I do want multimancy. Good point. Design question. Should challenges that restrict the spellbook like this also restrict enemy damage resistances? I don't think so, because I feel like part of the challenge is like overcoming that. Like, we're doing just fine at the moment. And thanks to Twilight Gaze, even if we didn't have an overwhelmingly powerful set of equipment, we'd still be, like, toughing it out. We wouldn't have Carnival of Pain going, that's entirely thanks to Crackle Darkener, but we'd be Wave of Dreading, Death Chilling, probably with Mass Death Chill. Like, the build would be similar, but a little different. The floors would take longer. Reroll. This looks good to me. So this is the kind of area where I'm going to want to cast two things to start. Twilight Gaze, then Carnival Pain, then Wave of Dread. But they won't be able to do 225 points of damage to me in that length of time. Especially because he needs melee to do big damage. Alright, Multimancy. There we go. More targets for Carnival of Pain. Alright, Twilight Gaze. Carnival of Pain. So broken. All right, army. Have fun with that one Lamasu I'm leaving there. Poor guy. All right, which army in one skull? Move out. Twilight Gaze, these gentlemen. Carnival Pain back on. Death Chill you. Life Drain you. Once I'm unfrozen, take a little walk to the left. Where all those people are stunned. Carnival Iron will pain back on. Oh yeah. Twilight Gaze, Death Chill you. Death Chill you. We have a Dredge. Job's done. Alright, what we got next? I really like those time shoes. Now, shock value. I think we might actually get some value out of shock value. Doesn't need to be a lightning spell, just lightning damage. And we certainly have enough lightning going around. I'm gonna take shock value. A strange collection. Oh man, immune to lightning and dark? These guys ruin everything. Thankfully, we have line of sight on the whole world. He didn't, because he stood here. Ah, that one hole took care of it. The only guy I'm not going to hit is you. Twilight Gaze. Carnival of Pain. Wave of Dread. Oh, hold on. Prince of Ruin. There we go. Knew I was forgetting something important. Wave of Dread. Oh, right. Immunity to Dark. All right. Twilight first. Yeah. Oh, baby. See, this is our fireworks display right here. This is 4th of July. It's beautiful. This one guy who's been outside my line of sight this whole time. Got you now. Yeah, pass that lightning damage back and forth. Good work. Grab shock value. Fiery Tormentor, Death Cleave, Drain Pulse, Night Hag. Let's pop a portal key here. Choose the best possible boss for us. Ophon's probably the best possible boss for us. See if we can get a good Ophon layout. Well, I don't want a sigil. Nor a spell. But just having that lightning damage pass around will probably be bad for Ophon. I'll reroll though. See if we can get lucky. No. No. I mean, winged shoes would be nice, just so I have a full set of garbage. But do I want to fight Pope? Pope the Frog? Don't want a sigil, but I'll look. That looks like a pretty nice level for me. Like, I like wide open like this. How much damage could you do to me? 29. Nothing could freeze me. Might start here, take two turns of setup, and then cast, just because it's the nicest level for me. Twilight Gaze. Level got a little not nice, thank you. Carnival of Pain. Oh my god. Explosions everywhere. Oh, say can't. Oh. Ophon, my friends. I have 5 teleporters. You mind if I stand next to you real fast? I see you made some immortal witches. That was very mean of you. I am definitely just broke my record for fastest Ophon kill. Turn 4 he died on? Jeepers. That is 100% the fastest I killed Ophon. Doodle-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Alright, turn 4 Ophon kill. That's my challenge for other people. Can you kill Ophon faster? Reaper, Draco Lich, Chaos Fiend. I guess I already have one Lich friend. Let's make more Lich friends. Alright, Mudrid. Hold on to your butts. I'm gonna race you quick. Unbelievably fast, right? Golden stopwatch. Twilight Gaze. Carnival of Pain. Death Chill. Wave of Dread. Right, you're shielded. Wave of Dread, I said. All his buddies died. I need friends in order for my build to work. Now I'm just stuck in a little corner. Let's see here. Is there anything else I want? We're not doing arcane. We're not doing fire. Don't have anything that's an arcane spell. So nothing in that category. I'll take Art Sorcerer just for Wave of Dread, I think. Enchantment, 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 and the Wave of Dread is our one not enchantment. Because I'm not sure what else I would want here. Like, in the dark category, I got all the good stuff for someone that doesn't have a minion build. Could have a Bone Guard hanging out, but I don't think so. What is the bouncy shield thing on the right that followed you across levels? That was letting us know that Ophon was losing and gaining shields rapidly. It's like a little visual leftover from an enemy we killed unbelievably fast. You know what? I see Necromancy. Art Sorcerer. There we go. Oh, there goes Mordred. Look at this man. Troll-blooded old Thunderbones. Hey, this is another one of the new enemies. Has a dark ball, applies fear. I guess like a lot of the new things have the fear because it's a new category. Placeholder art still, but that's all right. Oh, Mordred's afraid. He's afraid! Twilight Gazem. Phospholite, thank you for that subscription. How you doing? Doodle-doodle-doo-doo. Are you still death chilled? You are. You're life drained. I'll just wave of dredge you again. My witch army is pouring out. We got our first Dracolich. I'm just gonna stand here and watch. He died again. There we go. Shuffle the level. Vibin', cozy maxing, moisturize, and in your lane. Sounds nice. That sounds pretty sweet. Oh, Mordred, you should not have swapped places with me. Look what you did, Mordred. It's your fault. I like how long I have to wait for all the various crackle dark nonsense to finish. Alright. Twilight Gaze. Shoots out a little bit of dark damage that starts multiplying and passing around. My witches put dark damage in, starts passing around. Death Chill you. My witch entourage. Can I hit Mordred? I can. Yeah, get him. With my nigh unlimited spells. This guy has immunity to dark, doesn't he? Yep. Do I have line of sight on him? I don't. What's in this chest? Golden hourglass, sorceress amulet. I might just grab a skull necklace. We have ghosts. We could benefit a little bit. I feel like the level's mostly my witches and ghosts at this point anyway. And my Draco Liches, I shouldn't discount those guys. They're doing their best. Just gotta remember to turn Carnival of Pain back on every once in a while. Oh, those are copper fiends down there, aren't they? That's what's breaking the chain. Their little minions aren't 100% lightning resistant, but... Oh, they are! Yeah, 100% lightning, 100% dark. That breaks our infinite damage chain. Ruining everything. There you go, pass it back and forth. Keep going. Ah, one of them died. Yeah, skull necklace. Dark spells and skills gave minion damage. Actually, these guys are coming from an item, so they're not gonna benefit whatsoever. But whatever, I don't care. Death chill you. Patiently wait for Mordred to shuffle the level again. Please, Mordred, shuffle the level. I'd like ever so much to have line of sight on you. How long until you do? Oh, zero turns. I figured it out. You've made a way worse level. Thank you. Use one of my multiple teleporters. What we got in here? Some nice exotic pets. You know what? Why not? After all, why not? Why shouldn't I? A burning reaper? A fey Draco Lich? Take a reaper. Carnival Pain. Man, when you have Crackle Dark in your end, Carnival Pain, you barely need to do anything. You turn on one of the tools, and it kills stuff for you. Remarkably effective. How you doing? I would like to kill you again. Well, I guess I'll Twilight Gaze the one lich in front of me. Death chill him. Come on, Reaper. Get out there and kill Mordred. I believe in you. Nah, Mordred's gonna die in this. And any second, he's gonna pop. His health bar disappeared. Has to happen soon. 51, come on! Is Crackle Darkener better than Sprigmaker? It depends. In a vacuum, certainly, because of its potential for almost unlimited damage cycles. But if you do not have a means of dealing dark damage, Crackle Darkener stops working very well. Because the whole idea is, if an enemy takes dark damage, lightning damage is dealt to two enemies in a six-tile burst. And then with Carnival of Pain, which is if something takes lightning damage, we've upgraded the number of targets, but more people take dark damage, so you basically make it so it goes around in a circle. Like, this guy will take the dark, he'll pass the lightning over to this guy, and then this one takes the dark, and this one takes the lightning. Because it's more than one person is targeted, it loops back around to the same people over and over again. He's down to 6 health. And he's gone. I'm just vibing in this little hole over here. Ah, he moved me. Shuffle the level, that's good for me. Don't like the people I'm next to, but... It's a way wider open... I talk so good. I once won with Crackle Darkener, spending only 6 spell points all game, right? Like, Crackle Darkener is ridiculously powerful. Especially when you mix it with other stuff. Like, Spriggan Maker... It makes so much chaff on the level that it makes things a lot easier. But Crackle Darkener will just do the level for you. Like, we killed Ophon in 4 turns. That's insanity. Yeah, spread out the damage. Forge is pretty safe down there, unfortunately, but what are you gonna do? Do I have a line of sight on Mordred? I don't, but I have it on the Dracolich, so we'll remove the resistances from the Dracolich. Just a Mortal Lich, Do you think redeal damage is worth a nerf? Items or skills only trigger once in a damage chain? I'm torn on that, because part of the fun, I think, of Rift Wizard is by the end of the run, you can be very powerful if you get the right kind of stuff going. And I don't want to, like, remove that. Because I think that's... Like Isaac, you know, sometimes you find items in Isaac that make the game super easy. But it feels good, it's a lot of fun. I like being able to put, like, wildly overpowered builds together. That said, maybe? Maybe make it so the same target can only be hit by the damage X number of times? Because, like, this is really powerful because if we have, like, a circle of dudes, the damage keeps going around in the circle. But if it's like, I've already done this damage to this guy twice already, and then breaks the cycle, that might be an interesting way to tone it down. But at the same time, that would make me less excited to find Crackle Darkener. Like, it's a real treat when you see, like, oh shit, that's Crackle Darkener. Hell yeah. I was ready to be teleported. I already had my teleport in my hand. Nah, I did. I wanted that. Let's see here. I might just grab an upgrade for Life Drain so I have everything fully upgraded. Just so when the run ends, everything was upgraded. Just feels good sometimes. Makes no difference mechanically to me. I have an army of witches doing my bidding. How you doing, Mr. Clancy? How you doing? Finally broke into the last few areas in the Elden Ring DLC that I couldn't reach. More Rift Wizarding after this? Something else? I might do another challenge run since we have the Archmage Trials. My current addiction is definitely the Elden Ring DLC. But try and make sure I give you guys variety. So I'll do one more trial and then Elden Ring. Suffer and Menagerie is going to be the hardest challenge, I think. Like, we've done a impromptu version of that before, where we prioritized only support spells and took all of the shmushmushmas, the exotic pets. Plus, it's Wednesday! Every time he shuffles a level, it's just victory for me. Carnival Pain requires minions. Menagerie? That's gonna be the hardest one, but I'm willing to do it. We could pop in there. I guess there's another one that is potentially harder, but I think that one's gonna be in particularly pretty challenging. Mostly because, like, right now, you know, I'm rocking 275 health as a max. I'm already down to 127, so I've lost quite a bit. Menagerie, there will be no hearts. I will have 50 health the entire time. There's only pets. Some pets will definitely hurt me. Oh, you see, we got a chip damage loop going right now. We're literally doing one damage per turn. Look at it go. So this is gonna go until something dies. There we go. Oof. That was a turn. Oh yeah, I was supposed to upgrade life drain. Not that I'm using it. I stopped casting that spell a while ago. I use my last teleporter. Grab a enchanting dagger. Why not? And then Wave of Dread. This is his last life, I believe. Yep. 128 health left on that guy. I would like to go up there and apply Death Chill to him. Can you get other items or health from level warping enemies? Yes! Like Mordred, you could see we have spell points for days spread out everywhere. The problem is we only run into the level warping stuff in like the last two. Like Mordred does it and the bosses do it, like Yorgamander, Ophon. I don't think anyone can do that before that. Like, I don't think there's any 3x3 bosses we're gonna run into that have that power. Too little too late, Mordred. Too little too late. He locked himself in a corner. Coward. Corrupted Orb might be able to get us what we want. Look at that. Mordred's lucky. He's so far removed that he's only taken a little bit. Won't help him. That was a bad idea, Mordred. If I win with 69 health, I'll be quite chuffed. There he goes. We won with 69 health. Would you look at that? Beautiful. Beautiful. I look forward to seeing Carnival of Pain being the top damage dealer on every floor after we buy it. Well done, wizard! The Dark Wizard is slain! His beasts have been broken and made tame. The beauty of Avalon will be built again. Your soul is permitted to sleep and dream once more. So that was the Necromancer challenge run. With a bonus challenge element to it in that Deathbolt is bugged right now. So the ideal starting spell for this run, off the table. But we pivoted. We decided we'll take Life Drain, we'll make everything else after that enchantments, which was actually pretty sweet. Seems shields and resistance is much needed with only 50. Yeah, like, it's gonna be scary with only 50 HP. So yes, we had to take Life Drain, grab Death Chill that we could deal with crowds, and hopefully things that have dark immunity. Crackle Darkener showed up on Realm 3, and at that point, the run was basically over. We knew we were gonna be fine. Wave of Dread, I like Wave of Dread. Whoa. And then we got Carnival of Pain. Carnival of Pain at the top. It's gonna be Carnival of Pain, Crackle Darkener. Carnival of Pain, Crackle Darkener. Carnival of Pain, Crackle Darkener. I'm gonna be interested to see if it ever isn't that. So, yes. 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 Oh, witches, that's right. That one doesn't count. There was a true Lamassu. Witches were just beating true Lamassu's butt for a while. Back to standard. It's Carnival Pain and Crackle Darkener, the 1-2 punch. Spark Gold coming up in third, which makes perfect sense. Carnival Pain is turning all of our lightning damage into dark damage, and that lightning damage is getting redealt as holy damage. It's perfect. It was such a good, like, 1-2 punch of equipment right there. Incredible stuff. I kept taking these enchanting discs, but the plan was Death Chill, Wave of Dread, like a 1-2 punch there, but that changed. We got Crackle Darkener. Crackle Darkener, Fey Malevolence, doing decent work on Realm 18. Realm 19, we beat Ophon on turn 4, which I will never forget. Sorry, Realm 20, we beat Ophon on turn 4. That's my fastest Ophon kill by far. And then Mordred, Carnival Pain, Crackle Darkener, Fey Malevolence, Spark Gold. Excellent. See, this is one of those runs where the equipment really made the run. Something that wasn't possible in the first game, but is quite enjoyable in the second game. And 69 health. Nice. Nice. A wheel to choose? I'm okay with making a wheel. I have to pee, so I'm gonna BRB. And maybe I'll put a wheel to choose the next challenge run together.